Hey guys, it's Kevin, and this is the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 5. It's the Fold 5, and it's nearly identical to last year's Z Fold 4. As one of the first companies to enter the foldable market, Samsung's mainly been focusing on refinements for their folds and flips. In this video, I'll go over what's new with the Fold 5 and compare it to their flagship and my main Android phone, the Galaxy S23 Ultra. So without further ado, let's get started. Okay, the overall design hasn't changed much since the original Fold. It's still very tall and narrow. I feel like if Samsung wanted to create a more traditional sized phone like the Pixel Fold, they would have done it by now, but they're sticking with this form factor. The front and back glass were updated to the stronger Gorilla Glass Victus 2, and the armor aluminum flex hinge has been redesigned, but more on that soon. The Fold 5 is now thinner and lighter than its predecessor at 6.1mm unfolded and 13.4mm folded, and it weighs just 253 grams. The Fold 5 is only IPX8 water resistant, so it will survive in water for 1.5 meters for 30 minutes. And like any folding phone, there's no dust resistance at all, which is probably a folding phone's worst enemy. So the hinge is arguably the most important part of the folding phone. The phone's not going to work well if the hinge sucks. And the new Flex Hinge is one of the best I've used. It's smaller and thinner and with less moving parts. Here's an animation from Dave2D showing the inside screen folding in a more teardrop shape. It does put less stress on the screen, but the crease is still noticeable and feels the same. You'll also notice that the Fold 5 opens completely flat unlike the Pixel Fold, and the air gap is just about gone. Light will still shine through since there's two rubber stoppers on the inside to prevent the bezels from touching. But how nice is that clap sound when closing the phone? The fingerprint reader, power, and volume buttons on the right side. The back has this nice matte finish to it unlike the Flip 5. The Fold 5 starts at $1,800 and it comes in 5 colors this year. I got the best one, Phantom Black, but other colors include gray, blue, cream, and the Samsung exclusive Icy Blue. If I put the Fold 5 next to the S23 Ultra, then I don't really prefer one over the other. They're both made from premium materials, feel nice in the hand, and have that matte black finish. If you're interested in the Galaxy Z Fold 5, I'll leave a link to it in the description box below. Alright, let's move on to those displays. They're basically the same as the Fold 4 minus one thing, the brightness. The cover is a 6.2-inch dynamic AMOLED display at 120Hz. Has a resolution of 904 by 2316, making it a 23.1:9 aspect ratio. The Insight has the same technologies, with the exception of it being 7.6 inches with a resolution of 1812 by 2176, or 6:5 aspect ratio. Both of these displays can now reach up to 1750 nits peak brightness, which is on par with the S23 Ultra. I believe this makes it the brightest folding phone on the market. The bezels on this are as thin as you can get. Any thinner and you'll end up with those accidental touches. The same under-display selfie camera is here, and you might not see it when looking at it straight on, but you will in certain background colors or off-axis. After using the Pixel Fold's cover screen, the Fold 5 is a little too tall for me. Content is more compact, and I can't really reach the top corners of the screen. Typing on it is a little small too. I wish it was wider since I actually prefer using the inside screen more. Compared to the S23 Ultra, content looks normal, especially with the 19.3:9 aspect ratio, and videos don't get cropped out as much. Here's an aspect ratio comparison between both devices. If the Fold 5 had a cover display that's the same size as the S23 Ultra, then I would use it a lot more. Other than that, content consumption on the Fold 5's inner display is really nice. So the Fold 5 has the latest chip, the Snapdragon 8 Gen 2 for Galaxy. It's the same chip found in the S23 series. Performance on this feels just as snappy too. Apps open quickly, scrolling is buttery smooth, and multitasking is great. And it should, because I feel like a multitasking god whenever I use the inside screen. I can have Threads and X on one side, then Instagram on the other with a YouTube video playing in picture-in-picture. I could even take it further by having Chrome in a pop-up window. It's crazy. DeX is also supported if you're into that. Storage starts at 256GB all the way up to 1TB, and it's a faster UFS 4.0 storage. There's also 12GB of LPDDR5X memory across the board. When I was reviewing the S23 Ultra, I found the battery life to be a big improvement. I got about 7 hours of screen on time within 2 days on a single charge. But the battery life on the Fold 5 is not quite the same because of a few things. It's the same 4400 mAh battery as last year, and both displays are a lot brighter. Plus, I'm using the inside screen more, so the battery capacity isn't the best for a 7.6-inch screen. But this phone can last me the entire day, so it's good enough for me. When you run out of battery, the Fold 5 can fast charge up to 25 watts wired, 15 watts wireless, and supports 4.5 watts reverse wireless charging. In terms of performance, the Fold 5 and the S23 Ultra feel exactly the same, but I do notice a big difference in battery life. Also, the S23 Ultra does support faster wired charging up to 45 watts. For the cameras, I won't go into too much detail since it's the same as the Fold 4. The flash did move from the bottom to the right side though. There's a 50 megapixel main, 12 megapixel ultrawide, and 10 megapixel telephoto. Compared to the S23 Ultra, photos from the Fold 5 are more saturated and less detailed. In ultra-wide and low-light photos, both phones are very similar. The Fold 5 has a 3x optical zoom and a 30x digital zoom, while the S23 Ultra has a 3x and 10x optical zoom and the 100x space zoom. On the cover screen, there's a 10-megapixel selfie camera, and the inside screen has a 4-megapixel under-display camera. One thing I forgot to mention is that the Fold 5 can now record videos up to 8K 30fps instead of 24fps. The Fold 5 is running One UI 5.1, but there aren't many new software tricks that take advantage of the larger display. The taskbar now supports up to 4 recently used apps, and you can drag and drop one file in a different app. I said it before and I'll say it again, I'm not the biggest fan of One UI. I prefer the software on the Pixel Fold, but One UI does have better app optimizations, kind of. On the Pixel Fold, most third-party apps have a lot of empty space, but on the Fold 5, the app turns into a blown-up phone version. There's also a flex mode, where you can have an app on the top half of the screen with controls on the bottom. On the left side, there's multitasking, quick panel, screenshot, touchpad, and more. And some apps like YouTube and camera will have their own set of controls. Samsung will offer 4 years of software updates and 5 years of security. After using the Fold 5, I'll stick with the S23 Ultra. The cover screen isn't for me and the battery life could be better. What do you think about the Fold 5? Let me know in the comments down below. Thanks for watching, and if you haven't already, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you'll be notified when I post new videos. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye!